This is a quick demonstration to give you an understanding of origin and importance, one of the key aspects of the CSS cascade. We're going to be focusing on this H2 here, and we're going to give it a range of different styles. But first off, the color is currently black, and that's coming from the normal user agent style, and it'll set the H2 to a color of black. The first thing we're going to do is to define a normal user style. So we'll open up user.css, and in here we're going to write H2 color green. As you can see, the heading didn't change color. Why didn't that work? Well, we need to apply our user style sheet to the browser. Browsers use a variety of different methods to allow users to apply user style sheets. Internet Explorer allows you to upload and apply your own style sheets via Internet Options, then choosing Accessibility, and then choosing Format Documents using My Style Sheet. Safari allows you to upload and apply your own style sheets via Preferences, Advanced, and then Style Sheet. Chrome has a range of extensions that allow you to upload and manage user style sheets. One popular extension is called User Style Sheets. Firefox also has a range of add-ons that allow you to upload and manage user style sheets. One popular add-on is called User Style Manager. Now I'm going to use Safari, and the first thing I'm going to do is to open up the preferences. And then under Advanced, I look for Style Sheet, and I can go and find my own style sheet and then apply it. And you'll see as soon as that happens, the heading is now changed to green. So our user style sheet is being applied to the page. Next up, we want to define an author style sheet. So to do this, we need to go to our author.css file and go down to the bottom here, and we're going to write our first author style. H2 color blue. And if we reload, you'll see the heading has now gone blue. But what if we wanted to apply an important author style? We'd go back to our author CSS file and write a new rule. H2 color purple and then important. And if we go back and reload, our heading has now gone purple. And finally, if we want to apply an important user style sheet, we could do that inside our user.css file. H2 color red and important. Now, if I go to reload, you'll see in Safari, it actually doesn't load on the spot. You actually have to quit Safari and then restart, open up that page again, and now you'll see that the heading's gone red. So let's do a recap of what we've just done. First of all, when we open up the page, we were looking at normal user agent styles, and the H2 was colored black. We went then and opened up our user style sheet, and we created a normal user style and set it to H2 color green. Now that overrides a normal user agent style, so the H2 changed to green. Then we went into our author style sheet and we changed it to color blue. And because normal author styles beat user styles, which beat all user agent styles, the color changed to blue. And similarly, when we wrote an important author style, it changed to purple because that beats a normal author style, a normal user style, and a normal user agent style. And finally, we went back into our user style sheet and created an important user style to change it to red. And this one trumped important author styles, normal author styles, normal user styles, and normal user agent styles. So there you see the five steps of sorting origin and importance in action. Now, if you found that useful, you might be interested in a new course of mine called Understanding the CSS Cascade. In CSS, the cascade is everything. If you don't understand how CSS rules are applied by browsers, you're in for a world of pain. Over 5 lessons, you're going to learn how browsers sort declarations in order to determine which ones will win. The course includes a series of hands-on exercises on all aspects of the cascade, from user style sheets to important rules to specificity and more. Now, this course is for CSS beginners, but it's also for those who want to brush up on their knowledge of the cascade. Hope to see you there.